So when the sanctuary employees finally got to me and pulled the chimps away, I was rushed to a small emergency med clinic in a small town in South Africa. The chimps ripped off most of my scalp, took a chunk out of my skull, took my nose, both of my ears, put a nice gash in my face that's caused some paralysis. As you can see, they took most of my fingers, they destroyed my right wrist, they collapsed one of my lungs, they took half of my right foot, all the toes on my left foot, a lot of my calf, a lot more chunks out of my abdomen, my buttocks, you name it. You know, I was pretty much torn up head from toe. I had acute respiratory distress syndrome, and I went septic, in a septic shock several times. It was a really bad situation. In that first emergency surgery where they pulled me out, the doctor gave me just 22 units of blood just to keep me stable and get me through that first surgery. But since that day, I've had 26 surgeries, actually two of them just within the last few months, and countless hours of every type of therapy you can possibly imagine. Now, I'm not telling you all this to really captivate you. I'm telling this to describe the dire situation I was in, the situation that just a few months later would introduce me to two of the most important people in my life, Helen Stancool and Tony McNeese. Helen and Tony are both nurses over at SSM Health St. Louis University Hospital, and they're responsible for saving my life, for guarding and protecting me, pretty much from the second that they heard my story. Now, as my mentor, Red McComb, says, my life since the day I almost lost it is a miracle that keeps moving. Yeah, surviving was miraculous in itself, but that miracle didn't stop there. Helen Stancool is the administrative director of nursing, emergency, trauma, disaster. You know, one of those nurses that needs two business cards to tell you who she is. You know, remember how I said that no matter how beaten down and tired and hurting you are, you're going to put that coat on and go save a life? Well, that's what Helen did. After my attack, Helen was actually at home recovering from a heart attack that she had suffered just a couple weeks earlier. And what she said is on her couch, feeling sorry for herself. But she got a call one afternoon from her friend Joanne Coogan, who just so happens to be my uncle's stepmom. And it was that little connection that basically saved my life and sealed my fate and brought me back home. Helen said that when she received that call, she quit feeling sorry for herself and remembered what she was put on this planet to do, to guard and protect others. She immediately took charge. She went over to the CEO of SLU Hospital and basically said, if we don't get Andrew back here now, he's not going to survive. And with that, Helen secured my fate and, you know, brought me home. A young man with no health insurance, probably over $1 million in needed care, and she did it for me. She had already started even arranging my care while I was in South Africa. She reached out to SLU's chief of plastic surgery, Bruce Kramer, and asked him if he would put me back together. He readily agreed. You know, she worked with government offices and hospital offices to get my medical records back home, and she even arranged the flight to get me from South Africa back here. You know, I'd never even met the woman, she had never met me, and she was doing everything in her power to bring me back home and set me up with world-class care. And it wasn't really even until about 2.5 months after I got home, when I was discharged from the hospital and living with my mom, that I really got to know Helen. She would come to my house all the time. She would bring me food to fatten me up. She would tell me every day how proud she was of me. She kissed my mangled cheek and really, you know, kind of embraced me the way only a mother can. She really became like a second mom to me. She actually gave me my first shower after being out of the hospital, which, after 4.5 months, is one of the best feelings you can ever imagine. You know, she made sure I had everything I needed. She made sure I didn't have to worry about anything except getting better. You know, I can say that pretty much solid confidence that without Helen, I probably would have died over in that hospital in South Africa. My mom, myself, my beautiful doggy Angie, Leo, Helen, everything. But that miracle kept moving. Knowing that I would need all this home health care, Helen introduced to me and one of her best friends and colleagues, Tony McNeese. Now, Tony is also a registered nurse, and he's in charge of disaster outreach over at the hospital. And he came to my house pretty much every day, sometimes even twice a day to change my dressings, to give me showers, to make sure I had anything I needed. But it wasn't just that. What was really important is Tony became probably my best friend at a time when that's really what I needed most. You know, besides the dressing changes and the showers, and you know, I can confidently say that Tony's probably seen me more naked than any other man in the entire world. But you know, all joking aside, his impact on my life was huge. He was my best friend. And we talked and talked about everything, everything from my injuries to both of our lives, past and present, and what we want in the future. We talked about girls, movies, my dog Angie, more girls, what I want out of the future, and, more girls. And we laughed about it, we talked about it a lot. But Tony was also that person that, the only person I could really share the feelings I had, fear that I would be alone for the rest of my life, being disfigured and mangled and disabled. And Tony was the one that really gave me that confidence and a little bit of hope that would be my life. And I really wish you could have seen his face on the day recently where I got to tell him that I've met and fell in love with a really incredible person who has also devoted her life to taking care of others, most in need, guarding and protecting them. Now, when me and Tony would talk, he would cry a little bit, he'd get choked up, but he would always blame the steamy shower or the hot St. Louis weather. But that day, he didn't have anything to blame those tears on. He gave me TV, exercise bike, tons of movies. He takes me to movies. We really have become really good friends. I may not have died without Tony. I was already healing and on the mend, but I can tell you that without Tony, that passion for life that I had before I got hurt could have been extinguished. He really gave me that love for life back and gave me that joy that I needed to really keep moving forward and really keep me thriving and as happy as I am today. Now, the importance of these nurses in my life is immeasurable, not only because they saved my life, guarded and protected me. Their importance is immeasurable because they're saving my life. They've also given me the opportunity and the passion to take what happened to me, turn it around, and help others thrive like I have. Just over a year ago, SLU asked me to join their development team and build an institute that will treat traumatically injured patients and train the next generation of healthcare leaders to really live for others and treat the whole person. Once we officially open for business, we'll be able to help patients and their families get through trauma the same way SLU's helped me get through it. And it's really because of my St. Louis University nurses that all this is possible. So when you put on that coat in a few minutes, your life is going to change, I guarantee you. That moment's going to symbolize the beginning of your journey living for others, being their guardians and their protectors like my SLU nurses were for me. I'm standing here as living proof that when you wear that special St. Louis University School of Nursing white coat and live by the values you're taught here, you'll have the ability to change and save lives like nurses. Being SLU nurses, I really have no doubt that in the future, there'll be people like me standing up on a stage like this, telling stories about how you changed their lives and saved their lives and gave them the ability to thrive after feeling completely hopeless. So I just want to wish you all the best of luck. Congratulations. God bless you.